Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In this video, we will practice Power BI question related to removing unnecessary rows from the Excel source file and setting up column headers in Power BI. So the question is, you are using Power Query Editor in Power BI desktop to import an Excel file that contains only one worksheet. The data in the file starts with column names on row 5 of the worksheet. There are occasional blank values in column A of the worksheet. You need to remove the blank rows at the top of the worksheet and use the fifth row as the column headers of the table. What should you do first? So here on the right side, we can see we have Xzipit where the snapshot of the data set has given. There we can see there are a couple of rows which are not the data rows, such as first row that we can see there is a sales report label is given. Then on the third row, we can see it is period Jan 2018 to June 2020. So that is again period of the report, but it is not the data. And actual data starts from the column headers, that is on the row number 5, where we have month. And thereafter, we have years as the column name. And below that, we have sales data by each month. And under options, we have four options, that is remove empty value from the first column. And then option B is remove the top four rows. Option C is use the current headers as the first row, and option D is use the first row as headers. So this question has been asked in Power BI exam in various ways and multiple times. So let's look at the question in Power BI. So here in Excel, we can see this data where in the first row, we can see we have report header, that is sales report. Then thereafter, we have second row as a blank. Then we have third row that has period of this data. Then we have two blank rows, and thereafter we have data. So now let's import this Excel in Power BI and let's see how this data looks like. So here I have selected the file. So let's select the sheet 1 and let's import the data. And here we can see by default Power BI has given the report header, that is sales report, as the column name for first column, and thereafter for other columns it has given headers as column 2, column 3 and column 4. That is incorrect. And thereafter we can see we have couple of rows as the blank data or the report or the period information that we don't want in our data set. So we need to remove all these unnecessary records from this data set. For that we have to select remove the rows. So from here we can remove the rows. So let's select remove top rows. And here we have to provide how many rows we want to remove. So as we have column heading on the fifth record, let's provide the four number of rows to be removed. And now we can see on the record one, we are getting column heading. So let's select the first row as the header. And now we can see we are getting month as the column heading and thereafter years as the heading for the rest of the columns. So now we have data in pivot format and we need to unpivot it to consume this data. So for that we need to select the columns that we want to unpivot. Then we need to unpivot it in transform menu and we have to select all the unpivot column. Now we have data in relational format that we can consume in reports. So now let's go back to our question. So here we did two steps. One is we removed the top four records, that is option B, and thereafter we set the first record as the headers, that is option D. And as per the question, we have to select the first step, that is option B, remove the top four records. So that is correct answer for this question. And also, as I mentioned, this question has been asked in various ways in Power BI exams. So the other way for asking this question is where we have to select multiple answers from these options. So in that case, we have to select option B and option D. That is, after removing the top four records, use the first row as the header.